Hey there once again, YouTube. My name is Ben Ferraiuolo, and I am an amateur seismologist who hopes to eventually make a career out of monitoring volcanic and tectonic hazard areas. If you have not already, please visit my website. A link is posted on screen here and will also be listed in the description box below under my email address. My website has so much data and information already, and you would be extremely surprised as to what you would find. At the end of the video, I will quickly show some of the new stuff, but also please go check out Scott's new channel called the NW Geology Guy. He really has put out some great content so far, so go help his channel grow if you wish. Now here we are at the Upper Geyser Basin where Old Faithful Geyser resides, among many other hydrothermal features. Last night, we had one of the biggest swarms at Yellowstone for 2018, besides the February 2018 swarm and the April 10th through 11th swarm. Now the magnitudes were not all that large, with the largest being around magnitude 2.8, but remember something that most people on YouTube and elsewhere do not want you to know. Remember that magnitudes are important, yes, but they do not matter much when dealing with volcanoes. They can, but just listen to what I have to say. You know, they can give us an idea of the size of the process that is taking place beneath our feet. But remember, earthquakes and tremor caused by volcanic processes usually carry much lower magnitudes than tectonic events. That is why the most important thing to understand is the process itself of an event, not the magnitudes of the earthquakes caused by that process. I will show that earthquake swarm in just a minute that I just talked about, but first, I found out something really cool about a recent earthquake. So here we are at earthquake.usgs.com, or .gov, sorry, not .com. Now there was a magnitude 4.7 earthquake. Look at that. There's North Korea, there's South Korea, there's Japan. In the Sea of Japan, there's a magnitude 4.7 earthquake that struck very deep, around 434.7 kilometers in depth, on December 30th, 2018 at 1426 UTC. But that isn't the craziest thing. Yeah, that's pretty deep, but still. That's not the craziest thing. Why don't we check out the event page and look at the phases real quick? I want to point your guys' attention to something. Let me go to Origin. Here's the event page. Okay. Go to phases. Arrival time. So look at this. You know how we can click the arrival time here under phases? Here, let me pan this over real quick. You know how you could click arrival time under phases to figure out which station was likely the closest station to any given event? Well, this time I want to figure out the longest arrival time, so let's click it one more time and check it out. The phase here does not see P or S, as is the traditional P and S waves, but it says this phase from these three stations were PKPdf phases. Notice how everything else says P, but these three stations saw a huge arrival time. Look at that, 1,128.8 seconds. That's a long arrival time. And it's also called something different, PKPDF. So what does that mean? I had no clue what that meant, so I wanted to find out, and I found an amazing guide to earthquake phases and what the intricate ones mean. Let's turn this on. Here's the page that I found. I will leave a link to it in the description box below. It's from the International Seismological Center. And they have a bunch of different phases for the crustal phases. Okay, now let's look for PKPDF. Remember, each section of the Earth's interior, such as the mantle or outer core, can have different P wave phases depending on how the earthquake traveled. For example, we have to go all the way down to the core section to find PKPDF. For example, here's the crustal phases. Here's the mantle phases. Here's the core phases. Now check this out, PKPDF. Here we are right here, PKPDF. That's the same thing that we saw on the, that's not it, on the earthquake page. See, PKPDF, PKPDF. Look at what this says. This means that the P wave bottomed out in the inner core. Now let's look at the diagram real quick. Let me see if I can zoom in. Can I zoom in? I think I can zoom in, but the detail is not that great. So imagine you're looking at the Earth, right? This is not any specific part of the Earth or any specific earthquake. This is just a diagram of what the phases look like and what they are. So let's say there's a deep earthquake, exactly like the one that we saw at 434 kilometers in depth. Look at this. So the earthquake starts, right? And it says it bottoms out in the inner core. The inner core would be this center part right here. Look at that. It goes right through and out the other side. Isn't that interesting? I bet this happens every now and then, but it doesn't happen too often, and I think that this was pretty cool. And here again is the diagram of three different phases, but the only one you need to look at is the red one here for PKPdf, which is what the earthquake, the 4.7 under the Sea of Japan, did show recently. It literally passed through the mantle and the outer core, passing right through the inner core and came out the other side. That is pretty freaking crazy, guys. All right, now let's go check out the big swarm that hit Yellowstone last night. So last night, there was a pretty good sized swarm, guys, that struck just slightly to the northwest of the northern tip of Yellowstone Lake, and it carried rapid succession characteristics and is the largest swarm that we have seen at Yellowstone since the February 2018 swarm and the April 10th through 11th swarm. Notice we have borehole 208, YML, YLT. It happened pretty much directly between these two stations right here. So on the northern tip of Yellowstone Lake, yes, but it was just to the west underground right about here. As of right now, 1:05 p.m. Pacific Time, New Year's Eve, December 31st, 2018, they are still only reporting two earthquakes, and that's it. Now, I think this will definitely change in the coming days because, as I have said before, this is one of the biggest swarms to hit Yellowstone this year, besides the February and April events. The largest event so far was reportedly a magnitude 2.7. And let me pan this down just a little bit. 2.7 at a shallow 1.5 kilometers in depth. So far, for the magnitude 2.7 at 1.5 kilometers in depth, only one person has reported feeling it. Now let's go back real quick. Next, there was a magnitude 2.4 just to the southwest of the 2.7. The 2.4 struck deeper at around 4.1 kilometers in depth. This area you see right here, pretty much between borehole 208 and YML, which is right up here, this area is where the swarm occurred last night. It seems like the swarm struck again right between those two stations, so I will use those two stations, YML and B208. But I will primarily use B208 since it was a little bit closer to the swarm. Now, let's click the event page for the magnitude 2.4 at 4.1 kilometers in depth. They are saying only one person reported feeling this. But remember, if one person reported to USGS that they felt an earthquake, then it is likely many more people actually felt it. That is because most people do not know where to report feeling an earthquake, and some people just are not interested in reporting. Now here we are in the seismic program waves. As you can see, I have the data streams for the three seismic stations, YLT, which is in the middle, YML, which is down here, and borehole 208. All right, and let's go back. All right, if you are wondering where these stations are, I will show you. Here's Yellowstone Lake, West Thumb Lake, Mary Lake area. Here's Maple Creek, here's Hebgen Lake up here. So there's borehole 208 on the northern tip of Yellowstone Lake. Here's YLT near the northern tip of West Thumb Lake, and here's YML. So we have a good array of seismic stations in this area. The swarm happened right about here, just a little bit closer to borehole 208 than YML. So I will mainly use B208, but let's go back to the program waves. Before we get into analyzing this data, I would like to check and see how many earthquakes actually occurred as part of this swarm. I am not trying to accurately locate any earthquakes down to the latitude and longitude, but I am simply judging how many earthquakes took part of this swarm from start to finish based on the P wave arrivals on these three stations you see. I will count an earthquake as an earthquake if it appears on all three stations I have selected. It might show a couple of the earthquakes might be too small and only show on two stations, but preferably it would be on all three stations to count it. So why don't we get started? The swarm started around 7:10 UTC, December 31st, 2018, and ended around 12:45 UTC. We are about to find out how many earthquakes took place between that time period of 5 hours and 35 minutes. So why don't we start? Let's go to 7:10. Let's zoom in and let's do it. Okay. So first off, we have one. Let's go forward. There's two. Oh, let's go back to, let's see. Yep, three, four. I'm gonna just count that as five. Go forward. There's six. There, nope. So only six so far. Only six so far. And this is showing, so 7. That is slightly showing on the surrounding station. So 8. There's 9. There's 10. Now, bear with me, guys. This might take a couple minutes. So you can skip ahead of the video if you want. There's always going to be a parts section in the description box below. So we have 10 so far. Here is 11. And let's see. I'm going to say, oh, that does show down here. So I'm going to say 12, 13. Let's go forward a little bit. 15. Go forward. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. There's 21. There's a large earthquake. There's 22. It's 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. I believe that's 31. Yeah, I believe that's 31. Let's go forward. 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42. Let's go forward. Already at 42. And we're still at 735 UTC. So we're at 32, 33, 34. I'm just going to count that as 2. 35, 36, 37, 38, 40, 41, 42. Yep, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. See, yep, that's shown on all three stations. So 51, right? 51, 52, 53, and 54, 55. Very tiny though. So we're at 55. I'm just going to say 56. Keep going. 57, 58, 59. Yep. 59 was this one. So 60 right there. 61. Keep going forward. 62. See right here, we see one. 63, 64. Keep going forward. Keep going forward. 65. Sixty-six. 68, look at this. 67, 68, 69, 70. Let's keep going. 71, 72, and 73, I believe, but very tiny. So we're at 73 right now, guys. 74, and 75. Keep going forward. So we're at 75. Oh, that does show 76, but that one was extremely tiny. 77, 78, I'm gonna count that as 79. Let's keep going forward. 80. So there is 80, guys. What is this? That's not shown. Okay, so we're at 80 right now. Let's keep going forward. Keep going forward. So we're at 80. Come on, buddy. Any more? I know there's more. I know there's a lot more. What the heck is this? That shows. Oh, I'm gonna look at that later. That looks like a very weak, very small LF tremor. Very weak, though. So we're at 80, right? We are at 80. There's 81, 82, 83, 84, 85. Let's keep going forward. 86. There looks like there's a second one right there. 87. keep going forward. 88, 89, 90. Gonna say 91, 92. Keep going forward. 93, 94, 95. So we're at 95. Oh, 96, 97, 98, 99. This is number 99 so far. 100. That looks like a separate quake right there. So we're at 100 count right now. 100. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to say 103, 104, 105, 106. 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, let's keep going forward, 122, 123, 124, keep going forward. It's definitely 125. This almost looks more like a tremor to me. So we're at 125, right? I'm going to say 126, right about there. Going forward, 127, 128, 129. Keep going forward. 130, 131, 132, 133. I'm thinking 133 right about there. Wow, look at this. So we had 133, 134, 135. I'm just going to say this two right here, so I'm just going to say this is 135. Look at the low-frequency long tail of this earthquake. So we're at 135 right now, 136, 137, 138, 139, 140, I believe. So we're at 140, 141, let's see here, 142, 143, 144, 145. 146, 147, keep going. 148, 149, man, 150, 151, 152. Wow, guys, look at this. And there are a bunch of other smaller microquakes that I'm not counting that only showed on borehole 208, but they also probably were earthquakes as well. So we're at 152 right now, but I'm only counting the ones that show on, at the minimum, two stations, but preferably three stations. So we're at 152, right? Here's 153. Let's keep going forward. 153. Let's see, there's 154, I believe. 155. Let's see. I'm just going to count that as one. So 156, 157, 158. 159, 160, 161, 162, 163, 164, 165, 166, 167, let's see, 168, 169, 170, 171, 172, that looks like one earthquake right there. So 173, and don't see that one appearing. 174, definitely 174 right there. 175, let's see, 176, 177, 178, let's see, does this show? 179, 180 right here. 181, let's see, that looks like two, so 182, 183, 184, 185, 186, 187, 188, 189, my god, 190, wow, 191, check this out, guys. I know this is taking a long time, but my goodness, 192, 193, 194, keep going. This looks like a tremor right here to me. I don't know what type of tremor. I was at 194, right? I think I was at 194. I almost lost track. So 195, 196, keep going, 197, 198, oh my goodness, 199, 200, 201, 202, 203, two. What the heck is this? That's interesting. So 203, right? Did I say 203? I'm almost losing track. 204, 205, 206, 207, 208, 209, 210, 211, 212, 213, 214, 215, 216, 217, 218, 219, 220, 221, and 222, 223, 224, 225, 226, 227, 228, 229, 230, 231. So we're at 231, guys. 232. Keep going. Let's keep going. Keep going. Keep going. So it's 232. I'm gonna say 233. Don't know what this is right here. So we have 233. Let's see any more. 233. Do, 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 do. Come on. Any more? And nothing else. 233. And we're at 233 right now. Come on. Can we make it to 240? Here's 234. There's 235. 236, 237, 238, 239. Oh, 240, 241. What is that? 241. Can we zoom in? 241. I don't know what that is. That's very interesting. So we're at 241 right now. Think that's it. 242, 243, 244. And that's it. And we're at 1245 UTC, or a little bit after. So there were about 245 earthquakes within 5 hours and 35 minutes. Wow. About 245 earthquakes occurred as part of this swarm, and many occurred in such rapid succession that it was a little difficult to separate some of them. Now, let's just take a quick look at this swarm using data from Station Borehole 208 and the Seismic Program Swarm. Here we are in the seismic program swarm for borehole 208 during the time period. During the 5 hours and 35 minutes, we saw around 245 earthquakes. Let me pan this down. And you could tell there were two episodes where most of the earthquakes occurred. The first episode, which was right here, and then it calmed for about an hour or so, and then it did increase once again. The two largest earthquakes right here, I believe this was the 2 point. Let's check it out. 40,000. This goes to 20,000. So I think this was the 2.4 mixed in with another earthquake. And this right here was the 2.7, I believe. Also, notice something very interesting that you can also see on the spectrogram. Check out how long the tail is. Notice how the frequency is lowered, as it usually does. But look at this. Look at how long that tail is right here. Look at how long it lasts. Right up to here. 726.50 to about a minute. So the tail, including the earthquake, lasted around a minute. That's a pretty good length of time. And this almost looks like a hybrid earthquake. Notice how these almost look very similar. See, okay, so I'm thinking, so most of the events around West Thumb Lake and Yellowstone Lake that carry rapid succession characteristics, like we see in this swarm here, usually do not have events looking like this. And usually in the past, remember how I said at West Thumb, I believe a new hydrothermal system is forming, maybe a few new geysers are forming, or something like that. That is what's causing, in my opinion, the rapid fire swarms at West Thumb Lake. However, this occurred at near the northern tip of Yellowstone Lake, but just to the west. But this right here reminds me of the 2008-2009 dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake. We saw many of these. We saw many of these hybrid earthquakes eventually transform about a day or so later into low frequency events around about 1 hertz or so. And again, if you guys want to see a lot of the plots to the 2008-2009 dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake, go to my website. Go to the seismic events drop down menu and click 2008-2009 Yellowstone Lake. So this is what appears to be a hybrid earthquake. Much lower frequencies than we usually see, stronger than we usually see, and it lasts quite a while. Look at that. Let's see, 725.50, what was that? Let's go back. 725.50 was the 2.7, it's 725.50. So this was reportedly the 2.7, which goes to 40,000 amplitude count. Then the other one was right here. Let's see what time they say, 10:21:08. 10:20, so they say right here this was a 2.7. Or 2.4, sorry, excuse me. They said this one was a 2.4. But something they don't realize, these are three different earthquakes. Did they not see that? You can clearly, and the spectrogram does help. You can clearly see one earthquake right here, another earthquake right here, and another earthquake right here, with dominant low frequencies extending far beyond the initial earthquake, almost joining this earthquake right here, because it lasted quite a while. Do you not see that right here, this tail, this N10? You can also see that. Let me try to zoom in on just the tail right here. Let me zoom in on more of it. You can see how long it lasted. Zooming in more and more and more. Look at that. Still at about 1,000 amplitude count. So it lasted quite a while, guys. Let me zoom in on there. Yeah, see that? So it did have a very long tail. So we have hybrid earthquakes occurring in such rapid close succession, like six earthquakes in like 50 seconds almost, kind of like what we see at West Thumb Lake. But West Thumb Lake doesn't really see hybrid earthquakes that much. These are definitely reminiscent of the 2008-2009 dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake. Personally, you know, I try to be careful saying something's magma intrusion. And even if something was magma intrusion, that doesn't mean an eruption's definitely coming. I mean, look again at the 2008-2009 dike intrusion under Yellowstone Lake. That was a serious type of magma intrusion at Yellowstone, guys. It was worrying, but it never erupted. It never erupted. But you always got to watch out for this stuff, guys. Always keep an eye on a volcano when you see either low-frequency earthquakes or rapid succession hybrid earthquakes, like multiplet swarms. Look at all these, guys. Look at all these earthquakes. Let's go to the spectrogram. Let's zoom out real quick. Look at that. I'm going to zoom all the way out as much as I can, just so we can get a broad overview, as long as my computer doesn't freeze, because my computer's not really liking me right now. So using the spectrogram, you can see the first burst of seismicity, and then you can see that it calmed for a little bit. And let's keep going. A few earthquakes here and there, and then all of a sudden, it starts to pick back up momentum. And then we see more earthquakes, more earthquakes. Look at how many there are, guys. Remember, I said around 245 within 5 hours and 35 minutes. With a lot of them bunched together in a tight space. It would be one thing if the 245 earthquakes occurred during that time period, all spread out all around the place, but they weren't. They were bunched together. So I think, personally, it is my opinion this swarm was caused by magma itself. I usually don't say that for some of the swarms at Yellowstone. Sometimes I do. I used to say everything was magma intrusion, but that's before I realized that there are many different processes at volcanoes than just simply magma intrusion. I mean, there's, hell, I didn't even know there were different types of P-wave phases. There's like hundreds of them. Seriously. So let's keep perusing through. Now, during this time period, there was a tiny, tiny, low-frequency background tremor. Nothing major, though. You see that right there? Yeah. Dominant low frequencies. Let's check the spectra real quick. Dominant frequencies between 1 and 2 hertz, with the dominant frequency being 1.21 hertz. Let's go back to the waveforms. You could tell it was a low-frequency background tremor. Don't know exactly what's causing it, but if this is magma, a tiny bit of magma, then it is probably being caused by the small amount of magma. Let's go up here. 10 amplitude count. That's very, very, very tiny, guys. And then we go down here, and it's around 40 or 30. So still nothing major, but before one of the last earthquakes at 12:32 UTC, we did see what appears to be a low frequency event. This is not showing on many surrounding stations at all. I don't know what that was. This is definitely a telseism. That looks like a telseism to me. Let's see the dominant low frequencies. Oh yeah, yep, definitely a telseism at 0.5 hertz. Yeah, definitely a telseism. So, 245 earthquakes within 5 hours and 35 minutes or so. Look at these guys. Look at how many. Now, from here, 724.50 to 725.50. This whole time frame right here is 1 minute. I'm not going to change it unless I say so, okay? So, this is all within 1 minute, guys. Right here, we see probably one, two, three, four, five, six within a minute. Right here, we see multiple earthquakes within 1 minute. Building up towards that, let's look at the spectrogram real quick, and it's all messed up. Fog power? Come on, buddy. Okay, so here's where it started right here. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. My goodness, it probably sounded like a machine gun going off. Look at that. And this was the 2.7, which on borehole 208 showed stronger than the 2.4, which is what we should see. And all these swarms occurred just west of the northern tip of Yellowstone Lake. Let's go through this once more. Look at the long tail, guys, the long coda of this, especially this earthquake right here. Actually, you know what we should do? Let's check the dominant frequencies of this earthquake. My goodness, look at this. Below 3 hertz, with the dominant frequencies being about 2.4 hertz. And 1.4 hertz. But as you can see, there were some stronger frequencies going up to about 10 hertz. So, and also a little bit farther than that. So it cannot be labeled a low frequency earthquake. It cannot. It just cannot. But it had dominant low frequencies. Notice that? And we have some more popping off. Remember, 245, around 245 within 5 hours. And look at this again. This one looks like a typical hybrid earthquake. Let's take a closer look at that. Look at the dominant low frequencies right there. Let's check out how strong those frequencies are, real quick. Go to spectra. Of course, it had stronger frequencies going above, but around again, 2.4 hertz and 1.4 hertz, showing that it is most likely part of the same exact process. Now let's go forward. Multiple earthquakes again. Multiple, multiple. I mean, you could see them on the helicorder. Look at all those guys. Definitely one of the biggest swarms we have seen in 2018. One of the biggest swarms. Don't bite my head off. I said one of the. Look at all those guys. My goodness. With barely a tiny bit of low frequency background tremor. Notice that? Check this out. Right there. Let's check out the spectra real quick. Just to check it out. Yep, at about 1.4 hertz. 1.4 hertz. Kind of like what we saw with the earthquakes, showing that this low frequency background tremor might not be background microseisms. This actually might be connected to the earthquake swarm, even though borehole 208 at Yellowstone Lake does see low frequency background tremor from time to time ever since the 2008-2009 dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake. My goodness, guys. But some of these earthquakes are very reminiscent of the dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake. Go forward. This is when activity started to pick back up right around here. Notice the long tail, the long coda again of this earthquake. Multiple events, calms down. Let's go forward. Starts to increase, boom, and then starts to decrease, and then starts to increase slowly. It pops and it, oh, hello. I saw something. What is that? A little burst in low frequency activity right there, very tiny, only 100 amplitude count. So let's say this was real. These tiny, tiny low frequency bursts were real and actually coming from underground, but only had 100 amplitude count. That means that even if it was a real seismic event, it really wouldn't show on surrounding stations at all, sadly. But let's keep going forward. It increases, 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 increases. Boom, we got earthquakes. And notice how it almost looks like something is approaching, kind of like a very thick, viscous fluid is trying to break through some rock as it's traveling. Notice how it increases and increases and increases and increases and increases. And then boom, boom, boom. three earthquakes within about, let's see, 10:21:10, 10:21:40. Within about 30 seconds, we see three earthquakes, one of them being a magnitude 2.4 at, I believe, what was it, 4.2 kilometers in depth or 4.5? I forget. And then it decreases. Notice how it decreases. And look at, there's some earthquakes right here. One, two, three, four, five, possibly five right there. Possibly. But they are so close together that they almost look like a type of tremor. See, and then it decreases. Notice how it all leads up to this right here. It increases, 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 boom, and then decreases. Kind of like an eruption. I mean, obviously no eruption happened, otherwise it'd be all over the news, people would be freaking out. But it's almost like an eruption. That's kind of what I see during volcanic eruptions. And again, that low frequency background tremor is still there. Let's keep going forward. And then it pops off here and there for the next hour or two. But the main sequences are done for. Many earthquakes. Remember, again, 245 earthquakes within about 5 hours and 35 minutes. That is pretty crazy, guys. And I was actually able to record some of this last night on my Swarm live stream that I watch sometimes during the nighttime. And I watched some of these earthquakes come in on the monitor, which was pretty cool. And I recorded it too, so I'll post that on YouTube later. And also, I will try to download the seismic audio for this swarm right here. And I'll upload that in a separate video, so keep an eye out for that. Yep. So guys, that's pretty interesting. And that's about it right there. So some of these earthquakes had dominant low frequencies, but couldn't really be considered low frequency earthquakes. I think they're more like hybrid earthquakes. Again, you can see there's this tiny burst in low-frequency activity right before this one earthquake, and then everything pretty much calms down. Few other microquakes a couple hours later. Most recent data suggests the swarm is over. But again, as always, that could change in the blink of an eye. I mean, look at how fast this swarm approached, guys. And here is the largest set, one of the largest events. Look at that tail, guys. Just like the 2008-2009 dike intrusion. So personally, I believe what caused this swarm here is magma itself. The other swarms, the other rapid fire swarms that I study a lot, I believe that's related to hydrothermal activity. But due to the characteristics of this swarm, and just the sheer amount, not the size, but the sheer amount of earthquakes in such a small, confined time period, that shows me that something was definitely trying to break free down there, guys. And I do not believe it was water, that's for sure. And here we are at my website, https://monitorsize.weebly.com. There's also a link in the description box below under my email address. And please remember, there is no www in my URL for my website. I am still changing stuff around on my website as much as I can, trying to make it better. I now have two seismic events pages. Seismic events 2 is more for locations and kind of newer activity. Seismic events, the original page, is more for specific seismic events like Steamboat Geyser, the 2008-2009 Yellowstone Lake, low frequency events possibly caused by magma at Cascade volcanoes. And check this out. I just got something new. I just posted a new page to my website. Please let me know if there are any mistakes. I'm still trying to make this page here a little better. But I do have a bunch of info, more data and plots and info, though, on the Kilauea eruptions earlier this year. Notice everything you see here was created by me, unless otherwise stated. I show the collapse at Puo'o. Remember how the Puo'o crater collapsed? I show that, and there's the heliquarters for that. I show how the lava lake drained, and you can see some of the signals because the lava lake drained. And here's some plots of the tremor associated with the draining lava lake, some explosions. Now, volcanic eruptions at Kilauea Caldera. I recently posted a video to YouTube about some of the seismic audio for the seismic buildup prior to an eruption at Kilauea. Here, I have all of the plots for about 20 eruptions. Now, between late April 2018, which is when the eruptive activity started, to about the end of the eruptive activity, there are around 62 Kilauea explosive eruptions. I have about 20 of them on here. I have the plots for about 20 of them. And they're all in slideshow format. Notice how some of these earthquakes look very similar to the earthquakes that we saw last night at Yellowstone. Notice the rapid fire characteristics, except the characteristics themselves of the earthquakes are different. But notice I have pretty much all of the eruptions, guys. And I also show the plots of the Kilauea eruptions and how they were seen in Washington State on station NLWA and even farther away than that. And then seismic events 2. Oh, I haven't even updated it yet. Well, soon it will say Mount Etna right here, because I'm going to be making a Mount Etna page showing the plots and the data for Mount Etna since it erupted in its new flank eruption on December 24th. I will show you that soon. I'll probably get to working on that tonight. So I was just letting you guys know I have added some more things to my website. Lots of plots in here, guys. Lots of different images and seismic images. My website also teaches you how to do all this stuff that I am doing. Pretty much everything I know and most of my research is on my website here. Also, don't forget about the more drop-down menu. It has some good information too. Notice how it says Mount Etna activity right down here in the more drop-down menu. I did not mean to put that there. I'm going to put the Mount Etna page under seismic events. So please come check out my website if you haven't already. Again, https://monitorsize.weebly.com. And here we are back at the Upper Geyser Basin streaming webcam for Old Faithful and other geysers in the area. Last night we saw an earthquake swarm with a total of around 245 earthquakes in about 5 hours and 35 minutes. About half of that occurred in one pair within about an hour or so, and another half occurred in another pair about an hour later, spanning about another hour and a half or so. Very rapid fire characteristics, guys. Very, very just rapid fire. It's pretty crazy. Now, I believe these swarms are what is considered multiplet swarms, and they are usually connected to some type of volcanic activity beneath the surface. I do believe this swarm was caused by magma itself rather than hydrothermal fluids, which is again the theory on why West Thumb Lake sees such rapid succession events. I believe a new hydrothermal system could be forming near the West Thumb Lake area, but I do not believe that is connected to last night's swarm. Regardless, we should keep a watchful eye on the caldera because swarms and volcanic hazards can pop up with little to no warning. And sometimes they can pop up with huge warning for years. You never know. So, you know, for example, during the 2008-2009 dike intrusion of Yellowstone Lake, we saw only about 2 days or so of warning before magma started to reach the surface. And guess what? The geysers didn't dry up. The geysers in the area, I don't think they dried up. I think they were still popping off. So we really didn't get much warning for the dike intrusion at Yellowstone Lake, which could have led to an eruption if it continued, but it didn't. Thank God, because who knows what could have happened. I also hope you guys enjoy my website. Not only does it have a numerous amount of data pertaining to multiple different events, my website also teaches you how to download seismic data, how to find it, how to analyze it, how to find seismic programs, and much more. Remember, a link again is posted in the description box below under my email address. So please keep an eye on Yellowstone, and I hope you all have a good and safe New Year's Eve. Today is the last day of 2018. Can you believe we are only about 366 days away from the year 2020? You know, to me, that sounds so futuristic, yet everything feels normal. When I was a kid, I thought everyone was going to be flying around right about now, you know? I thought everything was going to be way more futuristic. You know, you guys have a great night and be safe, and I will see you next year. In other words, tomorrow. Remember, the truth is considered hate or fear to those who hate or fear the truth. Ben Ferraiuolo signing off. Keep an eye out for more swarms of Yellowstone.